curious. So as we move through the program this morning, and we head toward the lunch hour, I just want to remind everybody that we do plan to provide lunch for you here on site, so you don't need to be worried about that, or don't get up and leave to go out and buy lunch. We have plenty of food, and you'll pick up your lunch as we leave here and move to the breakout sessions. We all know that another aspect of pheasant hunting in South Dakota relates to tourism and to basically rural economies, especially for our motel, hotel, kind of small town convenience stores, et cetera, that live on the pheasant season. So, and I know that because when we have a bird count report like we had this past year, I get a lot of phone calls about, don't tell people because we want them to come. But we've certainly practice the policy that we stick to fact-based data, and what we get is needs to be made available to the public. But in line with the tourism aspects of pheasant hunting, we're fortunate today to have Jim Hagen with us, who is currently the Department Secretary for Tourism for Governor Dugard. Before joining the Dugard administration, Jim worked as a National Campaign Director and Public Relations Director for the Crazy Horse Memorial Foundation. Jim also served from 2004 to 2006 in the Rounds administration as Secretary of Tourism and State Development, overseeing the Division of Tourism as well as divisions dealing with economic development, arts, history, and tribal relations. Jim has a long history with state government. During Governor Bill Janklow's administration from 1995 to 2002, he served as Chief of Staff, a Deputy Chief of Staff, and Special Advisor to the Governor. In those roles, Hagen served as the Governor's day-to-day liaison with the Departments of Tourism, Transportation, Revenue, and Economic Development. Jim grew up in the northeast corner of South Dakota near Sisseton. He's a graduate of Aberdeen Central High School in the University of Southern California. That must be a mistake, isn't it? SDSU? No. Southern California. Jim's interests include domestic and international travel, reading, outdoor activities, fitness, film, and music. And I think you're going to really enjoy Jim's presentation. So welcome, Secretary Hagen.
It's like a cross between getting the absolute crap scared out of you and then also getting like exactly what you wanted for Christmas.
Well, you can have a bird pop up next to you, scare the living hell out of you, and it's that surprise aspect.
I can't wait to hunt and I can't wait to go drink beer at three in the afternoon after we hunt and sleep in and come have breakfast and be lazy all day and just kind of do whatever you want, go shoot birds. It's just a carefree kind of vacation.
Thank you very much. It's good to be here today. Secretary Blanc, thank you for coordinating this summit. Governor, thank you for being here and for coordinating it as well and for having the vision to hold this summit. As Dave just told you, pheasant hunting is incredibly important to our state's economy. Every day, especially as the fall season rolls around in our department, constantly what we're thinking about are those small towns and communities in eastern and western South Dakota where pheasant hunting is a lifeline for them. It's those mom-and-pop diners. It's the hotels and motels. It's the campgrounds. And so it is an integral, important part of South Dakota and an economic lifeline for a lot of our small communities. And so we're so grateful for the emphasis on this summit. A little bit of what I want to talk to you about today is who is the South Dakota hunter and where are they coming from? I want to talk to you a little bit about our media and our market strategy. I want to show you some of our creative messaging and how we're reaching those hunters outside our borders. I want to talk about some of the hunting partnerships and sponsorships that we have, and then we'll be available for some Q&A later in the day. But before I begin, too, I also want to introduce two members of my staff. Wanda Goodman. Wanda, if you would stand up, please. Wanda's my deputy secretary, also handles our media and industry relations. Justin Larson is our outdoor media rep, working with outdoor writers from all over the country, actually all over the world. So they'll also be here all day to answer questions that you may have. Unfortunately, I can't be here all day. I was planning to be. I'm going to head to the National Finals Rodeo tonight. I realized when I was about three quarters of the way here that I had forgotten my driver's license, and I have to catch a flight in Sioux Falls tonight, so I'm going to drive back to Pierre, get my license, then drive back to Sioux Falls. So I appreciate you letting me sneak out of here a little early, but Wanda and Justin will be here to, like I said, answer any questions that you may have. Based upon the inquiries that we get into our department, telephone calls we have, intercept surveys that we do, here is what the typical hunter that we're interacting with at our department looks like. They're 35 to 60 years old, married. They have a household income of $80,000. On average, they're taking 2 to 3 trips per year. Now, those aren't hunting trips per se, but they're traveling 2 to 3 times per year. When they are taking their hunting trips, they're spending over $900 on that trip, and they consider themselves definitely recreationalists. Here's a quote that we received from one of the guys that we talked to just a few months ago. He said, "I guess I would say we're professional recreators, men of leisure. We just like to be outdoors." Here's where our hunters are coming from. Now, these are based upon the license sales that we see through Game, Fish, and Parks, and this correlates very nicely as well with the inquiries that we see, phone calls again, emails, etc. Minnesota, Wisconsin, Missouri, Colorado, Iowa, Michigan, Nebraska, Texas, Illinois, and Kansas. Those would be the top, but actually we see hunters from all over. In fact, just about a month and a half ago as I was flying back from the East Coast into Sioux Falls, I was on a flight and I had hunters from South Carolina, Tennessee, Georgia, Maine, Texas, was on there, Arkansas and Alabama. So they are coming from all over. Here's how we reach those hunters. And in the messaging and the marketing that we do is very niche specific. So we're really looking to advertise on websites, through publications, magazines, television, etc., that are very niche specific to hunters. Basically on platforms that hunters are hanging out on, if you will. We have a great partnership with Pheasants Forever, and that includes a lot of things that we're doing through their magazine, banner ads on their website. We're able to utilize their mailing lists to talk to their hunters, and we have been a major sponsor of Pheasant Fest the last couple of years. So in Kansas City, Minneapolis last year, and in Milwaukee, I believe in February, we'll be a major sponsor. So if you're at Pheasant Fest, you will see a huge aisle that is just South Dakota. You'll see our banners hanging. There are a lot of things that we sponsor when we're at that show, but we have a huge presence at Pheasant Fest. We utilize a lot of niche-specific television, so you'll see us on the Outdoor Channel, Pursuit, Sportsman's Channel, Rooster Tells, Wing Shooting USA, The Flush, Pure Hunting. Magazines such as Covey Rise, Gun Dog, Pointing Dog, Shooting Sportsman, Upland Almanac, Minnesota Sportings Journal, Ducks Unlimited. We also have two great campaign co-op partners, one being here in Huron with the CVB, led by Peggy Woolridge, who's been terrific to work with, one in Watertown as well with Karen Witt, the CVB director there, and our partners. We utilize social media a lot. So our outdoor, Justin has a specific Facebook page, Twitter page, in which we're constantly messaging out to our hunters, and we do through our general platforms as well through tourism, but Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, our outdoor blog. You'll see your banner ads, again, very specific and strategically placed on websites nationally and regionally to reach hunters, and then we do a lot of targeted email messaging as well. And here's what we take into consideration with our messaging. You know, given where we are this year with the brood counts, one thing that we always want to be very careful with is that we're not sugarcoating things, that we're being very honest with our messaging in terms of what people can experience in this state. So again, keeping in mind that we're still the premier pheasant hunting destination in the country, bar none, we also want to sell the experience, though. We want to talk about the fact that you can get birds here, but it's about the experience when you're coming to South Dakota, and a shared experience with your buddies, with your family. Our messaging really focuses in on celebrating a successful day in the field with your dog. Celebrate taking the time to hang out again with your guys, your buddies, your family, your friends. One thing we also stress is South Dakota hospitality is like none other in the country. And that is one thing we constantly hear from our hunters is we have never felt so welcomed and at home. It's like coming home to family from our state when we come to South Dakota. And again, we're careful about not touting the number of birds as much as we are the bird volume guaranteeing a really good day. Here's just an example of our creative television.
It's world-class pheasant hunting in South Dakota. South Dakota, there's no place like it.
Here's some copies of our print ads. This year, our campaign message is there's no place like it, and a lot of different things that you can read into that. No place like it in terms of the birds, no place like it in terms of being able to experience the great outdoors, hang out again with your buddies and your friends. Chris Hull, actually Chris, who's been helping us here with some of the technical end of things, is the guy featured in the ad, which would be on your right-hand side. Here's an example of our digital banner ads, again, running on websites nationally, again, that are targeted very specifically to the hunter. Here's an example of some of the creative email messaging that we do. So during the pheasant hunting season, we've got a database of several hundred thousand hunters from throughout the country. Like to stay in constant contact with them, giving them information about, you know, not only the brood count surveys and things that we're finding, but, you know, weather reports, other things that are going on, some of the forecasts that we're seeing, et cetera. But these have been incredibly important to us. We get great interaction with the hunters, especially through these email campaigns. Another thing that we implemented a couple years ago was really to get all of South Dakota involved in our efforts. And so we started something that was called Rooster Rush campaign, and a lot of you have probably have seen, especially as you get through rural South Dakota and the eastern side of the state, a lot of communities that are participating in Rooster Rush. And essentially what it is just a welcome to these hunters. You'll see big banners welcoming hunters. If you stop at a convenience store in Miller, you can actually buy some t-shirts. Actually, they're on sale now for Christmas for $12.99. Rooster Rush 2013, if you're looking for those last minute Christmas items. But really what we want to do is be as helpful as we can to these communities to welcome our hunters from all over the country. And this is just an example of all the communities this year that participated in Rooster Rush 2013. And we give out grants to these communities to help them produce t-shirts and banners, et cetera. And we spent about $25,000 this year in just giving out grants to these communities. And this is just an example of some of the efforts that these communities undertake. Door clings on hotel rooms. You'll see some other banners that they're putting up, welcoming committees at airports. I think that's Aberdeen up there. Anyway, they just go all out. And every year at the tourism conference, we honor one community with the Cacklin Community Award, who's done the best job of participating in Rooster Rush and making our hunters feel welcome. We've also had a sponsorship with the Minnesota Vikings the last couple years. This year, we do not have this sponsorship, but in the last couple years, if you headed to the Metrodome, you would see the huge banners that we had on the press box, touting our world-class pheasant hunting in South Dakota. Out in the plaza, we had a booth and interacting with thousands of folks who were heading to the game. As you headed into the Metrodome, every entrance into the Metrodome, every exit to the Metrodome had our signage. We also sponsored one game. I'm happy to report in the last 4 years during our sponsorship, the Vikings won every single one of the games that we sponsored. So others have suggested that maybe we start sponsoring the entire season for the Vikings. If we can find the money, Governor, we may do that. Lord knows they need all the help they can get. We also had a great sponsorship with the Minnesota Twins. There's a picture of Kent Herbeck, Timmy Laudner from some of their World Series championship teams. Took our presidential mascots there. They were incredibly helpful, helping us tout pheasant hunting at a couple of Twins series, one with the Cleveland Indians and one with the New York Yankees, actually. Now, I'll show you an example of a promotional video that ran at Twins Stadium.
South Dakota presents Target Practice.
I can't wait till we can really get them.
Register online for a chance to win a South Dakota pheasant hunt with Kent Herbeck and Tim Laudner.
Rooster!
Pretty well received. That was a great sponsorship, and definitely we'll keep an eye out in the future and potential future sponsorships with the Twins as well. Again, here's some shots from Pheasant Fest. I believe this was in Minneapolis last year. Again, we take out our... take over a huge section of the convention floor, sponsor the little the bandanas that the dogs actually wear during their parade, the dog show that they have. This is, again, has been a great opportunity for us to bring partners in throughout South Dakota as well. So I think we have somewhere between 15, 20 partners that join us in the South Dakota aisle. Expecting we'll have even more partners this year in Milwaukee. And again, we work very closely with Game Fish and Parks as we put together our message, making sure that we're in line with the initiatives that they have going on. Our co-op partners as well, Watertown, Huron, have been fantastic to work with in helping us get the message out as well. We look forward to growing that partnership in the future and strengthening those partnerships as well. And in our office, when fall season rolls around, we're just as excited about pheasant hunting as we are about anything that we do. Our staff really gets into the season as well. You'll find on many Fridays, we're all decked out in our camouflage orange celebrating, and this was a shot just this last fall. And my parting comments to you folks again, thank you for allowing us to be here today. With our fall shoulder season advertising, pheasant hunting again is incredibly important to what we're doing. As I mentioned at the beginning of my comments, it's a lifeline for a lot of rural South Dakota economies. We really look forward to some of the solutions that may come forth from this summit today, and we look forward to working with all of you into the future. Thanks for having us here today.